Hello everyone, and I welcome you all to the All Computer Classes, Unit 3 and Chapter 8 we are doing. Today we are covering the Part 2 of Chapter 8. Okay, so let's see. These are the topics that we are going to cover today: creating a document, word wrap feature versus the enter key, formatting marks, saving a document using password protection, closing a document and application. Okay, so let's start. First of all, creating a document. Okay, so we have three ways to create a document. The first one is, after opening the application software, click on the file, go to the new option, backstage view will appear, and then you can choose the blank document for there. Second option is, you just press Ctrl N. Or third option is, click new button located in the quick access toolbar. So let's see how we can actually do this. So this is a MS Word interface in front of us. For example, if we want to open a new or we want to create a new document, so we can click file tab and we can choose new option from here, right? So we have a blank document option here and click create button. This is one method. Second method, Control N, right? And third method is to click new in the quick access toolbar. We have this option here, so we can have this, and we can remove this option also. Okay, so we learned how to create a document using three methods. Next is a word wrap feature versus the enter key. So let's know what is word wrap. While typing a text in MS Word, we observe that there is no need to press the enter key after finishing a line. Okay, if the text does not fit in a line, the word automatically shifts it to the next line. So we don't need to press enter every time. Okay, so this happens automatically. This is called word wrap. Okay, and what is the purpose of using the enter key? Enter key we use at three places: to place the text in the new line. So if I want to write few points, so I want to move intentionally to the next line, then I need to press the enter key. Or to mark the end of the paragraph. For example, this is a paragraph I have written. My paragraph is ending here, so I need to move to the next line. So what I will do, I'll press the enter key. Or to leave the blank line in between two paragraphs. Okay, so let's see how this feature works. We are going to see how the word wrap happens. We are learning features of MS Word. You just notice it will automatically move to the next line, and we find it very easy and simple to see. Automatically came to the next line. So this is how word wrap works. Now if I want to move to the next line, for example, my paragraph is ending here, so I want to move to the next line, I'll press enter. Or for example, I have this paragraph, I copy it and enter. I want to move to the next line, then I can do this. Or I want more space between the paragraphs, then I can do this. So this is how our word wrap and enter key works: to move to the next line when a line is ending, or to move to the next paragraph, or to give more space between the lines. Okay, I hope you have understood. Okay, so next is formatting marks. Formatting marks will tell us where all we have used tabs, space and enter keys in our document while typing it. Okay, MS Word has a feature to display some special character called formatting marks. To see how this works, we need to go to Home tab, click on the Show and Hide button in the paragraph group. Okay, so this is a Show and Hide button. This is a toggle button. We need to press this, right? Formatting marks do not appear on the paper when a document is printed. So you have seen that, like, all the words are having a space key present between. Right, so I have pressed some key, but that will not appear in the printout. right? Enter key wherever I have pressed, it will not come in the printouts, right? So it is, this is also called non-printing characters. So enter key, tab key and space key, they are also called non-printing characters. Okay, we have list of formatting marks, right? Wherever I have pressed space key, dots will appear. Okay, so dot shows how many times the space bar key has been used between each words. If you will see two dots between the words, it means two times I have pressed the space key. This is a paragraph mark. Okay, this character shows the position where the enter key has been used. So wherever you will see this, it means I have used the enter key. Line break, so to break the line we press the enter key. So this character shows where all the combination of shift and enter key has been used to end the line, right? And wherever I have used the tab, this mark will appear, right? So let's see where all we find these marks. So for example, I have pressed shift and enter key here to move to the next line, and for example I have given 2 times space here, right? And now I press here tab, here also tab. Now let's see, now let's find out all the marks. Now to use that, I need to go on home tab, that is automatically open here. In the paragraph group, I'll go here. So this button will appear. This button name is show and hide. Okay, so we can use control plus star button to show, to do this, right? So I will just press it. So you see I have pressed 3 times spacebar here. You see this button, all the tabs have been used. So enter key have been pressed here. So this is how this show and hide button works. So next is saving a document. We have 3 ways to save a document. The first method is click on the file and go on the save option. Second is press control and S key from the keyboard. Third is click save button on the quick access toolbar. If you do any one out of these 3 methods, save as dialog box will appear, right? And the document will be saved with the file extension .docx. Dot, right? So this is the file extension that you will get. While saving this document in the MS Word, you will have more option to save document with different file extension. Like you have this option RTF, that is rich text format, HTML for web page, dot text to save the plain text, XML Word XML document, WPS Word 6 to 9 document, and PDF for portable documents. So you get these options. You can save your document with these file extension as well. So let's see how this works. For example, this is my document and I want to save it. First method is to go here and click on the save. So this dialog box will appear. Okay, it will ask me the name. I have more options from here. So I just told you the plain text, rich format, PDF, and many more options are there, right? Like work 6 to 9 document. So I can save it with any extension. The document will appear in that format then, okay? But by default it will have DOCX extension, right? So let's give it a name. Let's give it a name, saving MS Word, right? So I can save it, or I can press Ctrl S to open that dialog box, or I can go here and press save button. So I have this file option, I have this save option from the quick access toolbar, or I have option Ctrl S. So 3 methods to save the document. Next is saving document using password protection. This is very interesting and very useful feature. So how we can do this? We need to go to the file tab, select save as, and in this save as dialog box we get this tools option. The moment we will click on the tools option, we will get a drop down list and general option is to be selected. The moment you will select the general option, you will get this dialog box in front of you. So here you have 2 options, password to open and password to modify. Okay, if you need to give a different password for these, right? If you want to give permission to anyone to just open and do anything, then you can give this. And for modifying, you want to allow it to modify, you can do this, right? So let's see how this works. For example, this is my document and I want to save it. So first is go on the file, go on the save as dialog box, then go on the tools option, and from here you have to go to the general option, right? Now this dialog box is in front of us. I want to open it with password 12345, right? And okay, so I need to re-enter password to open this, right? So I'll 12345. Okay, so it is going in this PC. Okay, so I'm pressing save. Now I need to close it. You see, I have just clicked on the document. It is asking for the password. So I will enter 12345 and okay. Now I can open it. Okay. The same procedure I can follow. Click on save as, go to the tools, go to the general option. Now I want to give the password for modifying. So I'll give ASDFG. Okay. ASDFG. Okay. Save. Now I can modify it. So I hope you are clear with this. Just try it out. If you face any problem, just tell me. Next is closing a document and an application. So there's a difference between these two. We need to see it. Okay, so click on the file tab and close option to close the document. And if your document is not saved, it will ask you to save. If you want to save it, you don't want to save, or you want to just cancel it. So what is the meaning of these three options? Save, the document is saved and then closed. Don't save, the document is closed, then all the modifications since the last save are lost. If you cancel it, nothing happens and you return to the document, right? And exiting the Word application, there's two things: closing an application and closing the document. So let's see how this works. Okay, so this is my document and I want to close it. So document closing means just closing it. The document is closed. Okay, because it was already saved, so it did not ask me for any option. Let me take a new and I'll show you. New, blank, create. Now I write something and I did not save it and I want to close it. So it is asking me to save, don't save and cancel. So if I'll click save, so it will ask me for name. So probably it has taken some name. Closed. So this is document is closed. All right. So if you want to close the application, so we have two options: click file and exit. Second method is just close from here. Right. So we have two ways to close it. Okay. So that's it. I hope you have learned a lot of things today, and keep practicing. And if you face any problem, ask me in the comment section. I will clarify it. And see you in the next video. Take care and God bless you all.